Most of the commercial studies that I'm involved with currently relate to hepatitis C. Hepatitis C is a viral infection that causes liver damage, usually over many decades, and it then leads to cirrhosis and to liver cancer. So the whole aim of our treatment has been to get in there and cure people of this viral infection before those problems can develop. Over the last decade or so, there's been a huge explosion in the development of new drugs to treat that disorder. Our current drugs are, although fairly effective, so currently we'd cure 6 out of 10 people with the disorder, but at the expense of a long course of treatment with a lot of side effects. It's pretty tough stuff to take. So the idea of the new medicines is that they will be more effective and much easier for patients to take, which really would take us to a different level in terms of getting rid of that disease from our population. The trials that are running at the moment are new treatments which don't involve the toxic part of the combination interferon predominantly. So these are all pills, and although there's a lot of pill taking for patients, these seem to be very effective treatments at initially blocking the virus, making more virus, and then allowing the body to eradicate it with this combination of drugs. These studies are predominantly run on our biomedical research unit at the moment, and that involves assessing people's livers with things like FibroScan, which measure how much scarring there is in people's livers. So this is a substitute, if you like, for liver biopsy, which obviously is still the gold standard at telling you how bad somebody's liver is. But it's an invasive test with a complication rate. What FibroScan does is to allow you to non-invasively measure the amount of scarring in the liver. It's a very simple technique where you just put a little probe on the skin and fire a shockwave through the liver, which sounds dramatic but doesn't hurt. The speed at which that shockwave goes through the liver tells you how stiff the liver is and how scarred it is. So patients will come for that assessment, usually as part of their workup for the trial, because we know that badly scarred livers respond less well to treatment. Once people have gone through all those assessments, they would then start the trial, which usually involves a large number of visits to hospital, rather a lot of blood being taken, but no actual interventions. Most of the medicines they take are taken 3 or 4 times a day, although the newer agents are perhaps once or twice. And they have to be taken at very regular intervals. So one of the key pieces of equipment you need for your trial is your mobile phone with an alarm. You can get an app now that tells you when your tablets are due, and it will automatically remind you in 6 different ways. But that's pretty critical for these medicines to work. They have to be taken all the time. The good bit about it, I think, is seeing at the end of the study, because these are quite short treatments now, 12 weeks or so, that a person who previously would have been made very ill by our treatment with a 50-50 chance of cure has felt perfectly well all the way through 12 weeks of treatment. The virus has gone at the end of it, which is fantastically rewarding. There are a number of things that would incentivise clinicians, I think, to get involved in clinical trials. It's the best route of access to me for my patients to treatments that we know are going to be a huge step forward. So if you take the area that most of the commercial trials that I've been involved with is in hepatitis C, we all know there's a huge explosion of drug development to treat that condition. And the agents we get in clinical trials working with pharma at the moment are going to be our standard of care in 3 or 4 years' time. So I think it's a huge opportunity for patients primarily. The second part of that is as a treating physician with these new agents, get experience 4 or 5 years before anybody else does. So I'm used to using those agents, familiar with them, and it certainly helps me in terms of that process of introducing new treatments when they come along. So I think all of those are very cogent reasons why people should be engaged with pharma. Once you actually start the process of setting up trials, I think you see, you know, at each stage there are key things that you need to do to engage with industry. The first is communicate with them through their CRO or directly as often as you can, even in setup, to make sure that everybody knows where you are in the time process. And linking that to working internally to hit their deadlines is the other absolutely key thing. So obviously a commercial trial costs millions of pounds a day to run, so every moment extra that this runs on costs everybody money, and in the end will come down to increased costs of that medicine when it comes to market. So I think everybody has to be focused on that, but by working with with the R&D and making sure that they're all aware this is a commercial study with tight timelines, you can usually manage that interface very well. But I think that the absolute key is internal relationships and the face that you put to CRO and company.